Welcome to this brief monsoon outlook produced in conjunction with Monsoon Awareness Week. The week of June 9th through the 14th has been designated as Monsoon Awareness Week in Arizona. This outlook is produced in cooperation with the National Weather Service in Tucson and Flagstaff, as well as information from the Climate Prediction Center. The North American monsoon is defined as a shift in the overall wind pattern from the typical dry spring westerly flow throughout the atmosphere to a southerly or southeasterly flow. This wind pattern is due to the development and position of a summertime subtropical high pressure system. Once this high pressure system becomes established over the region, moisture is capable of being pulled north into Arizona from both the Pacific and Gulf of Mexico, eventually becoming manifested into thunderstorms. The position of this high will dictate whether the monsoon is active with frequent thunderstorm or inactive with little or no thunderstorm activity. When the high is located over eastern New Mexico, Colorado, or the Central Plains, this is generally favorable for thunderstorms in Arizona. However, when the high shifts into northern Mexico or becomes situated directly over Arizona, this situation is generally unfavorable for thunderstorms. Several studies have attempted to link the conditions in the Pacific Ocean to the onset and magnitude of monsoon thunderstorm activity in Arizona. Although this relationship does not hold every year, there is some correlation that shows when La Niña conditions are present, that is, when cooler than normal sea surface temperatures over both the central and eastern equatorial Pacific are present, along with a negative Pacific decadal oscillation, that is, cooler than normal sea surface temperatures in the east-north Pacific basin, when these occur, the flow pattern becomes favorable to bring moisture and thunderstorm development into Arizona. The opposite is true during El Niño and the positive PDO phase. This year, we have been in an ENSO-neutral stage that is neither a La Niña or El Niño, and this is expected to continue through the autumn season. Recently, a tongue of cooler water has emerged off the South American coast, resembling the onset of a La Niña phase. However, this is expected to be just a temporary phenomenon. The Pacific decadal oscillation was much more evident earlier in the year and now just shows a weak reflection with just somewhat cooler than average temperatures along the North American coast. Given the absence of weak measures of these anomalies in the Pacific Basin, the teleconnections are expected to have little or no predictable influence on a North American monsoon structure or persistence. Many times a subtropical high will set up and become quasi-stationary over regions of extreme drought where soil moisture is significantly lacking. This regime provides positive feedback where the hot dry weather bakes into the ground and then reinforces the strength of the high pressure system, and so on. This year the most extreme drought is located over eastern New Mexico, west Texas, southeast Colorado, and southwest Kansas. While drought occurrence is not the only mechanism to force the location of the subtropical high, this current drought area could be favorable for moisture return into Arizona this year. The truth is, we really have very little skill at predicting the strength or persistence of the North American monsoon. Not only are conditions in the atmosphere changing throughout the summer season, allowing periods of activity and periods of inactivity, but thunderstorms and heavy rainfall produced by the monsoon flow are typically isolated in nature. In this example from last August, there were locations in central Arizona that saw over 3 inches of rain that would be above what would be considered normal, while communities just 50 miles away saw 3 inches less than normal. Active monsoon periods can last only a few days or several weeks and become aligned over just one area. In this example, southern Nevada received persistent thunderstorms in August, while southeast Arizona only saw occasional activity. When considering the lack of climate signals from the Pacific Ocean and the underlying lack of skill in predicting monsoon rainfall amounts, the Climate Prediction Center has indicated that Arizona will see equal chances of above, below, or near normal precipitation during the monsoon season. This forecast is also supported by an ensemble of climate models, which shows no preference towards a wetter or drier season this year. So in summary, there's really no reliable climate signals to indicate a wetter or drier monsoon season this year. Even in the best cases where there is some signal, we really only have limited prediction skill given the aerial and temporal nature of the thunderstorm activity in our area. Regardless of the strength of the monsoon this year, there will be periods of thunderstorms. They'll have lightning, strong winds, and blowing dust. You'll want to prepare for these thunderstorms ahead of time and know what to do to keep yourself and your family safe by reviewing the information that was presented in this past Monsoon Awareness Week. For more information, please visit our webpage at www.weather.gov/phoenix for up-to-date information and the latest forecast products. The National Weather Service is also on Facebook, so check us out our page and like us to follow along with us. We're also on Twitter and YouTube, posting updates with weather and climate information. Thank you for tuning in, and have a safe monsoon.